more and more in the knowledge of you, for your desire is that fellowship, have a personal relationship with us.
Mm-hmm.
And that's our desire towards you. So we thank you, Lord. We recognize that we're a blessed people.
Yes.
We thank you, Father God, that we are healed today.
Yes.
We thank you that we're prosperous today. We thank you that we have the mind of Christ today. We thank you, Lord, that we're walking in love today. Father God, we thank you for the precious pastor that you brought to us from India today, Father God.
Mm-hmm.
We thank you for increasing him more and more.
Yes.
We thank you that
Lord,
every need of his ministry is met.
Mm-hmm.
In the name of Jesus and in the life in his life.
Amen.
Thank you for our Reverend Stephen and the beautiful Laura, his beautiful wife Laura, fellowshipping with us today,
thank
Father God. We just love you so much, Father God.
Mm-hmm.
And we recognize that without you, we can't do anything.
Nothing.
But with you, we can do all things. So we just pray your blessing upon this body of believers today.
Mm-hmm.
We pray your blessing upon every person today that's worshiping
mm-hmm.
in your name, giving you the glory and giving
mm-hmm.
you the honor. And we thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Praise
awesome God.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. You know, it's an awesome concept. Matter of fact, it's a mind-boggling concept to know that we can have intimate relationship with God.
Amen.
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 I'm talking about the God of the universe.
Amen.
Amen. I'm talking about the God of heaven and earth.
Amen.
The God who told the sun where to rise, and he told the ocean, you can only come so far.
Amen.
That God that scooped up a handful of dirt and blew into it the breath of life, and man became a living soul. That God wants a fellowship with us. Isn't that awesome?
Oh, yes.
I tell you, I have to wrap my head around how much God loves us, that he wants to have intimate friendship with us. See, just to know a little bit about God would be amazing. But he wants us to know a lot about him. He wants us to be on intimate terms with him. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know about you, but that just fills my heart with joy.
Amen.
Just to know him.
Yes.
Millions of Christians know God as the creator of heaven and earth, but having a personal relationship with him is really where the intimacy begins. It begins when we become a part of his family by giving our lives to Christ. Amen?
Amen?
And after we do that, then the Holy Spirit begins to work on the inside of us. And he helps us to have a fulfilling and exciting relationship with God.
Amen.
See, our walk with God shouldn't be boring.
Nope.
It shouldn't be a chore for you to come to church on Sunday and Bible study.
Nope.
We should be excited. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
We should be in expectation of what God's going to do next. You know, what is he going to do next in my life? Why? Because he daily loads us with benefits.
Right.
He won't withhold any good thing from us. So when we wake up in the morning, we need to say, something good is going to happen to me today. Because I'm a child of the Most High God. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit teaches us through the Word the fear of the Lord. Now, there are many promises in the Word that talk about what you have as a result of the fear of the Lord. And next week, if it's God's will, we're going to talk about the promises for those. But this week, I want to concentrate on what is the fear of the Lord. We need to understand what the fear of the Lord is so that we can understand what it is not, okay? The fear of the Lord doesn't mean that you are to be afraid of God. Why should you be afraid of God anyhow? He created you to have fellowship with him. He created you to be intimate with him. See, you never lose sight of the fact that God loves you with an everlasting love. Amen?
Amen.
So there's no fear. He's our Father. It doesn't matter who you are, and it doesn't matter what you have done. God loves you.
Amen.
And nothing can separate you from his love. Amen?
Amen.
In his word, God has clearly defined the fear of the Lord and what it means. Let's look at Proverbs. Proverbs, the 8th chapter, verse 13. Praise God.
Amen.
We're going to talk about the fear of the Lord.
Amen.
Proverbs 8:13. If you have it, say amen.
Amen.
And it reads, the fear of the Lord is to hate evil, pride, and arrogancy, and the evil way and the froward mouth do I hate. The Amplifier says the reverent fear and worshipful awe of the Lord includes the hatred of evil, pride, arrogance, the evil ways, and perverted and twisted speech I hate. All who fear the Lord will hate evil. Therefore I hate pride and arrogance, corruption, and perverse speech. Now the word arrogance means an offensive display of one's own importance. Okay, an arrogant person feels like they know it all. A lot of them aren't even teachable. You can't even tell them anything because they have a know-it-all attitude. Amen. They're so full of themselves.
Right.
They think the whole world revolves around them. Well, God says that He hates that kind of an attitude. Amen.
Amen.
From these verses, we can see that the fear of the Lord is to hate evil. The more a person fears and respects God, the more they will hate evil. This means we have to have the same attitude towards sin as God has towards sin. Amen?
Amen.
That means if God calls it sin, we can call it sin. God has a zero tolerance for sin. He loves the sinner, but He hates the sin. Why is that? Because by His very nature, He is holy. He is a holy God. Amen?
Amen.
He said in Leviticus 19:2, you shall be holy, for I, the Lord your God, is holy. God would not compromise with sin, and neither should we.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Proverbs 3:7 says, fear the Lord and depart from evil. When you have a respect for the word of God, you will not practice a lifestyle of sin. See, I have a problem with Christians that say they love God, but they are practicing a lifestyle of sin. We all miss the mark on occasion, but we don't practice a lifestyle of sin. Amen?
Amen.
Always know, because God is a just God, He will never tell us to do something that He won't equip us to be able to do it. Jesus has already dealt with sin. Sin is not a problem. He dealt with all our sins, past, present, and future. Amen?
Amen?
And because He lives on the inside of us, whether we are living holy or not, Jesus is still holy.
Amen.
So what happens is when we walk in obedience to what He tells us to do, His holiness will start to manifest through us. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things have passed away. Amen?
Amen?
Because He that is in me is greater than he that is in the world.
Amen.
So because He's on the inside of me, when I yield to Him, I die to myself and I become more like Him. Galatians 2:20 in the New Living Translation says, my old self has been crucified with Christ. Hallelujah. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. So I live in this earthly body by trusting in the Son of God who loved me and gave Himself for me. Each day we should be striving to live holy. Amen?
Amen.
Why? Because God is holy.
Lord.
I'm living holy because I'm saved, not to get saved. Amen. I'm already saved, so now I want to live holy. And a lot of things that I would do, I don't do because Christ is in me.
Amen.
2 Corinthians 5:14 says, the love of Christ constrains me. See, I have been around some people I wanted to slap. Amen. I've been around some people I wanted to tell them a thing or two. But the love of God, knowing that it wasn't pleasing to the Father, kept me from doing it.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
The same power that raised Jesus from the dead lives on the inside of us.
Yes.
It's the power of the precious Holy Spirit, and He gives us the power to live victoriously.
Mm-hmm.
See, Romans 6:14 says that sin no longer has dominion over you. The devil can't make you do anything. If you sin, it's because you choose to sin. Amen?
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 Amen.
So the first thing we see is that the fear of the Lord is to hate evil. Another definition of the fear of the Lord is found in Malachi. Let's look in Malachi, the last book in the Old Testament. Malachi, the 2nd chapter, we're going to look at verse 5. And we're talking about the fear of the Lord, the reverential respect of the Lord. Malachi 2:5. And I'll be reading from the New King James Version. And it says, my covenant was with him, one of life and peace, and I gave them to him that he might fear me. So he feared me and was reverent before my name. Another version says, he stood in awe of my name. There's just something about the name of Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
There's something about that name that's above every name, above every principality, and above every power. The name of Jesus. Now, in this verse, God is talking about his covenant with the Levites. They were God's ministers. And the Levites turned a lot of people away from sin because they had a reverential fear just for the name of God. Amen?
Amen.
Even before I got saved, I never took God's name in vain. But I hear people take God's name in vain. And I tell them quick, God's last name is not damn. If you want to call him something, call him I am. That's, if he had a last name, it would be God, I am. Amen. So I tell people that's not his last name. And if you start saying God, I am, you'll start cursing.